puck is dropped. Game four is underway.
And we saw this exact same situation last night when San Jose was in Colorado. And if this game is anything like that one was, look out. You're in for a beauty. That one went all the way into overtime before Joe Sakic won it for the Avalanche.
Tampa Bay down the right side. Afanasenkov over the line. Going in very deep. He takes the hit there. Lightning dig it free. Andrechuk looking. Still with it. Lost it there on the side. Sundstrom takes it over. And just sends it down for Montreal.
And look for Montreal to do the same thing that they did in game three. Come out and play as hard as they can, as physical as they can. That's the only way they're going to beat the Lightning. They've got to play that type of game. I'm sure Claude Julien's got his troops ready to play a very physical, at least opening period.
58 minutes in penalties, by far the most in the previous games. We saw that on Tuesday night. A lot of it happened in the first period. Icing is the call. Let's join the third member. Guys, let's show the challenge has been met by Javi Bulin.
And nobody knows this guy better than John Tortorella. He's had him in Phoenix. He's got him here. And he knows what buttons to push on. He told us that this morning.
Behind the net, Kubina looks for it. For Tampa Bay. Lightning trying to move it out of their zone. Yeah, Bulis is there. Canadiens sending it. Bulis' shot was redirected wide. Out at the right point, Komisarek. That shot is blocked by Modine. Tampa Bay blocks a lot of shots. Sidor checks his man behind the net. Puck is free for the moment. Center in front for Bulis. Ribeiro's after it. Ribeiro finding Bulis, and that's blocked as well. Out to the right point, Komisarek holds. A long shot is blocked in front as well. The shots are not reaching Javi Bulis. Here's Ribeiro, who's really struggled in the playoffs. Only have a one good game. He takes the hit.
And they need Ribeiro to come through for them. Ribeiro was their leading scorer during the regular season, and he has been virtually invisible against the Tampa Bay Lightning.
The booing is because Le Cavalier's out on the ice. They were booing him the other night when he touched the puck. Tonight they started to boo him just when he came out on the ice. Left side, Koivu. And the captain is broken up.
And they've got Richard Zednik back on this line, which means that power line has been put back together by Claude Julien. Speaking of which, Claude Julien, who had a remarkable run when he was the minor league coach in Hamilton, that's what got him the job up here in Montreal. He's the only remaining coach that is debuting their playoff skills. He's in his second season with Montreal. He was an Edmonton employee that was coaching Hamilton. And Andre Savard, the then general manager of the Canadiens, paid a draft pick to Edmonton to get him.
Right around the boards, Andrechuk can't move it out. Canadiens keeping it alive in the offensive zone. Broken up there, though, and Andrechuk is able to clear. 40-year-old sends it the other way. Afanasenkov getting there first. Breezeball with him. He scored a goal the other night that most people thought was going to be the game winner. It wasn't. Kovalev at the circle, snaps it. That one's blocked, and it goes off the netting, forcing a whistle. 17:06 to go in this, the opening period. What a playoff Coleman has had after a very disappointing regular season, both with the Rangers and at the end here with Montreal.
Yeah, but when he got to Claude Julien, he had a meeting with him after game one of the first series against the Boston Bruins and says, look, you've got to go with me and give me some ice time. I cannot be effective for you with 11 minutes ice time. So Julien threw him onto the line with Koivu and Zednik, and they've been great ever since.
Shot from Komisarek is deflected behind the net. Boyle lost it there. Ribeiro digs it out. Pays the price as Boyle runs into him. Boyle, without the stick, kicked it. It comes back the other way. Tampa Bay picking it up, clearing it off the boards. Corey Stillman, long shot, high and wide to Theodore. Boyle in deep, flips it around the boards to Modine. He's also had a good playoff run for Tampa Bay. Here's Stillman, checked there by Soure. Soure muscling in, but Tampa Bay still gets the puck. Richards behind the net on the pass to Modine. Wants to wrap it around. He finds Stillman. Back the other way to Richards, who had two goals the other night. Big shot, Stillman right through the crease. And it comes out of the zone.
There's a lot of things to look for early in this hockey game, and then most of it is who's going to score first. When Montreal scores first in the playoffs, they're 3-1, but when their opponent scores first, they've lost 5 and only 1-1.
Crowd into it early here, 16:07 to go in the first.
There's Corey Stillman, who got that dynamic goal that started everything for Tampa Bay in the game three. Of course, it was a shorthanded goal right before he scored the goal on a breakaway. He had a previous breakaway and been stopped by a great defensive effort by Soure. But then on the same exact shift, they lost the puck again, and down he went, and he didn't make any mistake on that one.
Pratt will pick it up now as the Lightning move it out of the zone. In neutral ice, it's Andre Markov. Markov with a flip. The stick of Perreault picked up the other way. St. Louis flies over the line, wristing it in its block off the netting. Marty St. Louis, a lot of people think he's going to be the Hart Trophy winner this year.
Wow, he's an absolutely fantastic season for the Tampa Bay Lightning, and he well deserves the MVP if in fact he gets that. He already has gotten one trophy to put on his mantle, and that's the Art Ross for being the leading scorer in the National Hockey League. And he has been effective. He was greatly effective against the New York Islanders, and he's been greatly effective against the Montreal Canadiens. Three assists in game one.
Around the board, Soure towards Rive. It's too far for him. Cleared out of the zone. It bounces right back into the Canadian zone. Rive is chased by St. Louis on a line with LeCavalier and Fedotenko. Off the boards. Pitching in with Sidor. Missed the puck, but LeCavalier covers up for him. That was very well done by LeCavalier.
Well, nerves and overconfidence are two psychological factors in this first period. Are the nerves of the Montreal Canadiens going to be bad? And is overconfidence going to be a problem for the Tampa Bay Lightning?
Hit there, then Tenko comes out in front towards Fedosenko, who just came on. Tenko checked by Rive. He's trying to work him over in the corner. It goes behind the net. Looked around the boards. This one goes wide of Theodore. That's Kupina keeping it alive. Fedosenko looks. Kupina gets it. That one's blocked by Koivu, but the Lightning still have it behind the net. At the left circle, Sidor's in deep. Waited too long, and that deflection goes off the net. And there's another stoppage.
Well, Andre Markov has taken a lot of punishment throughout the entire playoffs. He got really nailed by Joe Thornton in the first round of the playoffs. Here tonight, he blocks a shot. There's been a lot of blocked shots in this series, but look at that. Right off the side of the foot, that hurts. For the shot from Martin St. Louis. But one thing about Andre Markov, he comes back each and every game. Even when he's gotten hurt, he has not sat out any period. He's been back before the end of that actual period.
Game-winning goal for him in game three of the last series against Boston. Perreault wins his faceoff. He won 16, lost only three the other night.
That's an amazing stat, 16-3.
That last faceoff, though, Montreal lost it and ended up losing the game late. Here's Perreault shooting it in its glove there by Javi Ruhlman, and he hangs on for a faceoff in his own zone.
You talked about Yannick Perreault and faceoff abilities, and he went into that last game taking that huge draw with only 16 seconds to go. And I still think he lost it. I think he might have been credited with a win. Look at that percentage. It's amazing. This guy has led the National Hockey League five straight seasons in faceoff winning percentage. And he's out there for every important draw, and why not?
Andrew Chuck versus Juno, two vets there. Bouillon's shot is blocked again. It doesn't reach anywhere near the net. Tampa Bay may block more shots than any other team in the NHL. Not just the defensemen, the forwards do it too.
Well, it's interesting how John Tortorella has talked about that, and Craig Ramsey talked about it with Joe Micheletti, and we'll get to that a little later.
Here's a flip in front. Sundstrom scores!
Took a lot of heat for that game-tying goal in game three, has redeemed himself. Joey Juno gets the puck over to Sundstrom, a beauty backhand. And this is one of the ones that Nikolai Habibulin has allowed to go in on a straight shot. We haven't seen this in games one through three, but finally they have found out here that he is invincible. And don't forget that stat about the first goal scored. We talked about it earlier. This is a huge goal for the Montreal Canadiens. Huge confidence booster.
And it comes from one of their role players. Claude Julien said this morning, your best players have to play well in the playoffs to succeed. Then you look for help from some of the lesser-known guys, and Sundstrom's in that category. Over the line, that's Richards, the feed. Modine is in deep. Couldn't get the shot off. On the point, kept it there by Pratt. Quick shot block, Canadiens coming back. Juno with the lone assist, at least for now, on that goal. Lifted off the boards. Lightning trying to move it out. That's the first time in this series
Sweden. He played on the line with Naslund and Forsberg. That was at the World Junior Tournament. And in New York, he played with Gretzky.
Not a bad line. Over the line. The Cavalier with a flip. Theodore stopped it, and he covers it. Oh, it's deafening here in Montreal, where the Canadiens lead by one. Cavalier for the draw with Koivu. Koivu draws it straight back. Andre Markov around the boards. The flip out to the point. This shot blown by Theodore. Now he leaves it off. Around the boards towards Zednik, and that's beyond everybody's reach. Koivu, Zednik, and Kovalev. This was the line that did so well against the Boston Bruins. It was broken up in the Tampa series.
And Zednik has done absolutely nothing in this series so far without these two guys. He's only got three shots on net in three games and has been held pointless.
Around the boards near side, and Zednik taken out. St. Louis centers it, it's blocked. Kept alive by Fedotenko. Delayed penalty here from Mick Magoo for something that happened in front of the net. Did Markov get the Cavalier?
Yes, they did. The two old rivals that went at it in game three just went at it again. And it looks like Mick Magoo's calling a two-minute high sticking penalty on Andre Markov. They went at it real strong in game one. You'll see it here. There's the big almost hit. Just not quite in the, not in the, quite in our screen. It was up above in the slot area. But Andre Markov went up and hit the helmet, at least, of LeCavalier. And as we said in game three, anytime you touch the plastic with your stick, you're going to the box.
First power play, and they'll drop the puck again.
Now, Jimmy Dowd has done a great job, not only on the faceoff, but also on penalty killing and cycling. He has had a tremendous playoff during the Boston series and during this series against the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Tampa Bay's power play is strong in the playoffs, only 11%. Here's a chance in front of it. Shot stopped by Theodore. Richards holds it in the left circle. Looks to set things up. Stillman. Now Richards. Behind the net, Andrychuk. Looking. Boyle, a shot in front, and that's knocked down. Modine was looking for some room. The breakout for Sundstrom over the line. Big slapper. Glove that held onto by Javi Ruben. Faceoff is coming up.
And Dave Andrychuk, almost the hero of game three because of that faceoff win. Watch what he does here. Watch this. Lifts the stick up. Sheldon Suri almost ended up in the first row of the seats. Andrychuk took the puck and almost stuffed it. That's a cagey old veteran.
Great in the power play, playoff-wise, but also regular season. 270 power play goals, the most in NHL history.
So he's pretty good on the power
play. Oh, yeah. And at age 40, he still scored a lot of goals. Lightning with a minute 22 left on a man advantage. Trying to get themselves back even in this hockey game. They trail 1-0 on the Sundstrom goal. Dejan with a block there. Far side, Andrychuk holds to Kubina. Drops it off. Lead pass from Richards. LeCavalier couldn't get through. You can hear the buoy know as soon as he touched the puck. Kubina to the left circle. Held up there by St. Louis around the boards for LeCavalier. It's in the Cavalier holds. He's checked there by Guillon, and it's clear.
And they're trying to go after LeCavalier just like they did in game one, but LeCavalier is not responding. And Tortorella talked about that this morning in practice. He says hopefully it's a growth experience with LeCavalier, and he'll channel his anger a bit better tonight.
Drop pass there. This is LeCavalier. That was dangerous, but kept in, and Modine couldn't redirect it. It could have been a breakaway for Montreal. Like this could be. Maybe a two-on-one. If Bullis could have caught up to him, but it's too far in front. It was looking promising for Montreal. And look out there for the giveaway. But Tampa Bay comes away. St. Louis fell. Giroux picks it up. He has Bullis with him. Big shot. Knocked down by Javi Bullis. Here's Dan Boyle with 6 seconds left of the man advantage for Tampa Bay. Boyle will take it on the off wing. To the corner he goes. Check by Brion. Behind the net, Brisebois to Markov. Penalty's over as Markov's back on the ice. Here's Bejan, looking back in, stopped by Javi Bullin. He hangs on to be another faceoff coming up. No, he let it go. Well, actually the whistle blew. There's just no way for us to hear it. Only one shot
on that power play.
Steve Bajin's one of their hardest working role players. Look at this backhander. I guess he's trying to take a page out of Sundstrom's book, trying to do it again to Javi Bulin. But in tonight's game early here, not even 10 minutes gone, it's the role players that are coming through so far for these Montreal Canadiens. Are they ever working hard? The guys like Sundstrom, Dowd, Bajin, they're really working. They're getting opportunities.
Faceoff coming up. Left side of Javi Bulin. Koivu's in for the draw. Faceoff was won, though, by Tampa Bay, and it comes out of the zone. All the way back to the Montreal end. Theodore wanders. That was a dangerous flip. He wasn't sure who else was there. Saku Koivu leads the team in points in the playoffs. Koivu's pass. Kovalev in deep. Trying to center it, it's blocked. Alex gets it back, and Kovalev will hold on to it. Good stick work. Zednik save, and the rebound came out. That was Zednik's best chance of the series. Kovalev checks his man there. All his lines all fired up. Here's Kovalev for Zednik. Blocked there by Tim Taylor. And the Lightning break it out. Got a sight call.
What great physical work by Alex Kovalev. He's not known for that, but boy, on Corey Sarich, he's the bigger, stronger defenseman. He bumped him around and ended up taking the puck away, and then a great one-hand pass out to Zednik.
Loose in the corner, down, around the floor. Komisarek paid the price. Sidor gambled to keep it in. Sundstrom dug it out for Juno. The two ringers crisscross, and they cross again.
But he was just a special goaltender. I watched him many times in Winnipeg, and I watched him after that in the IHL, and he was just a huge talent, a confident kid, and it was a move we thought we had to make.
We appreciate your time. Good luck, Rick.
Thanks a lot.
Nice.
Thank you, Joe. That trade looks awfully good for Tampa Bay Lightning.
And you know, this whole Tampa Bay team has been put together by people like Rick Dutton. There's been four general managers of the Tampa Bay Lightning in their history, and they're all in this building tonight, believe it or not. Of course, Jay Feaster's the GM right now. He followed Rick Dudley as general manager of Tampa Bay. Before that, it was Jacques Demers for a short period of time. And, of course, Phil Esposito, who a lot of his draft picks are in this lineup tonight, and important draft picks, he started the franchise.
Phil is doing radio. Tampa Bay Lightning tonight. McCallaghan on the far side. He's wrapped around by Koivu. 1-0 Canadiens lead on a Sundstrom goal. Out at the right point. Missing it was Kubina. And he flips it the other way. Lightning get control of the puck back. 8:25 to go. In the first. Kubina from 60. And Theodore looked like he misjudged that one. Here's Benatenko keeping it alive. For McCallaghan at the circle. And was overskated by St. Louis. Hope checked into the corner by Kubina. McCallaghan with goals in three straight games. It's coughed up nearly to Benatenko, and now it's out of the zone.
Boy, that was dangerous right in front of their own nets. But Andre Markov out there every single time LeCavalier's on the ice, roughing him up, stiffing him, pushing him, seeing if he can get him off his game.
8:04 to go. First period. Sundstrom with a goal as LeCavalier gets a breather. John Tortorella said today that the other night he had 6 minutes in penalties, but he didn't want to curb his enthusiasm, as you said, wanted to channel it different, because he said guys, young guys like LeCavalier, have to learn this is what the playoffs is all about.
Well, Tortorella sees this as a growth experience for his organization for the future, which is refreshing to hear a coach say that. Usually those are the words that come out of the GMs. The coaches are only worried about that night and that game.
Yeah. No doubt the playoff experience that Tampa Bay had last year was a help to them this year. Over the line. Heron, off the deflection of Theodore, saved out of a skate.
That was a huge save because of the redirect off of Breezeball's skate. Those are harder to judge. Theodore looks right on his game.
Puck set in behind Javi Bulin. The consensus tonight is that Theodore is going to have to outplay Javi Bulin for the Canadiens to lengthen this series. Heron will dump it in. Bouillon. Dinkman lost it there. He takes his man down. Guess that's ruled incidental contact. Except for the fans in the stands. They wanted to call. Here's Boyle. Four of the period. So it's 4-on-4 hockey as the Canadiens back it up. A lot of open ice here at the Bell Center as Rive sends it in around the boards. Sarge goes the other way. Bumped by Juno. Hops in front. Rive, big shot. Look what Javi Bulin found right there in the glove.
Oh, Javi Bulin snagged that. I think that was really going over the net, JP. But Rive really put everything he could into that one. This one errantly came out right off of Javi Bulin. He just puts everything into it. I think it would have gone wide.
Yeah.
But Javi Bulin gets the glove up there nevertheless.
There's a
quick look in traffic. And here you see the little shot of the walk giving Bajen the shot from behind. That's what drew the unsportsmanlike call.
It wasn't a lot, but enough, I guess, to get the call. Here's Kubina. 4-on-4, under 7 minutes to go in the period. It's another good first period for Montreal, just like they had in game 3 on Tuesday night.
They've only allowed 4 shots on Theodore, so they're doing something right here again tonight like they did in game in the first period of game 3.
Theodore swings it around. It comes back the other way to Markov. Andre Markov will hold. Between the circles it comes. Up ice, Ribeiro to Ryder. Ryder's pass picked off. Ryder got his first playoff goal the other night. It was a big one. Coming back over the line. Sidor, big shot. Redirected. And it missed the net. Montreal dodged one there, and they come back up ice with Rivet. Soray's after it. Slowed down. Soray got it back. Flips it in front. Javi Mullen will cover it up with Ryder on the doorstep.
Well, Michael Ryder scored a huge goal for the Montreal Canadiens in game 3, but tonight he might have made a rookie mistake, and he got away with it just a couple of minutes ago. When you're playing 4-on-4, you got to make sure you cover up if the defenseman's caught out of position. Watch this. He goes forward. He has to go backwards. That caused a 2-on-1. Look at this. It was almost a 3-on-1, but Sidor was right in, and they're lucky that Kubina didn't bang that rebound in.
Off the draw in the Tampa Bay zone. Canadiens sending it in deep for Kovalev. Checking in his man as Kovalev. He gets it, centers it out at the circle, brings one. A survey holds the shot. Save. Javi Mullen, the late penalty coming up here.
And it's coming up to Kovalev for goalie interference. He banged into Javi Mullen in the blue paint. You can't touch the goalies in the blue paint. They're calling it in every series.
Pratt missed the net. Javi Mullen was on the bench for the extra skater, and now possession. Other penalties on the board. And those will go for another 24 seconds. That will become 5-on-4. Right now, Tampa Bay 0-for-1 on the power play tonight with one shot. And while they had the power play, the Canadiens shorthanded actually had 2 shots. Shot didn't win that faceoff. Goes the other way. The other night, there's a lopsided edge in the faceoff category. Montreal won 65% of the draws. No one on Tampa Bay had a winning record.
But they didn't win the big one.
Right. That's the one that Montreal's still talking about. Andrew checks over the line. May have been offside. He'll hold on to it. Plays it to the left. St. Louis will hold. Takes it into the circle. Looking. Andrew Chuck now. It's a 5-on-4. Two players come back out of the ice. Canadiens break. Big chance. Short-handed. Got that shot off. It was deflected wide. Look at the hustle from Bajan. He runs hard there. Into Le Cavalier. Won the puck. Great hustle from Bajan. Up it goes beyond the point. That's okay by them. They're killing the penalty. What a shift by Bajan.
Excellent shift by Steve Bajan. Montreal Canadiens were not good at shorthanded goals this year. In fact, they were second worst in the NHL in the regular season. They only had 5.
Boyle comes through on the right. Around the board, Brisebois takes the hit. Modine sweeps it. Left point, Richards. He holds. Right side to Boyle. At the circle, it's LeCavalier holding it. Center point. Richards fires. Tip save. A rolling puck, and the Lightning could redirect it home. And now it's cleared by Montreal.
And if Corey Stillman had a bit better bunting skills, he probably would have been a 1-1 game because he just missed that puck in the air when Theodore wasn't right over to the post.
Richards dumps it in. Richards with 8 points in his last 6 games, including the 2 goals the other night. Modine for Richards, holding it on the left point, backs it up around the boards and goes towards Stillman. 13 seconds left on the Tampa Bay power play. And that one is not what they want. It goes all the way out of the zone. Boyle is going to play it all the way back. Javi Mullen tries to help him out. For Lukowicz. And Lukowicz leaves it off to Boyle. Montreal gets a great round of applause from their fans for that penalty kill.
Well, we've talked about it all series. Tampa Bay is not good on the power play. They're 2-for-12 in the series, but one of them is a 5-on-3 goal.
Turn over the line. He grew up. Montreal area. Comes around the boards. Up towards the point. Brat. That's a high and deflected line. The theater. Taylor's after me. He has some help from Perrin. Got a second. Nice move around. Freeze ball. Skate save made. What a nice move by Jan Mikhailenko.
Yeah, but you shouldn't be able to do that to a veteran like Brisebois.
Correct. Brisebois. Around board for Taylor. The check down. Oh, look at Fouillon working hard. Maybe too hard. He's got to let him go. He's still going after Taylor.
And Nick Nicholas got both these guys now.
The gloves are off. Whoa, Taylor just landed a few. Fouillon was the aggressor at the start, but not in the end.
Francis Fouillon is a stocky little fighter, but born in New York City, but he is French. Here's the start of this whole thing. Taylor knocks the lid right off of the head of Fouillon, and then they get at it.
You know, Taylor was so disciplined, he didn't want to draw the penalty, but in the end, he had to go. Well,
Taylor's not a fighter. So Fouillon is out there doing his job, playing hard. I'm sure Coach Julien wants that. But you know what? Coach Tortorella will take that trade-off at any time. He'll take his Tim Taylor, his good utility player,
right,
to take one of the Montreal defensemen off the ice.
2:49 to go in the first period. But if anyone thought Montreal was going to come out and lay an egg in the first period, that is not the case. They've come out with fire, and they've got a 1-0 lead. Same kind of fire that we saw in game three. We didn't see it in games one or two. Flip by Perron. Five each for fighting. Fouillon and Taylor, and another whistle. And again, we haven't heard a single whistle here tonight.
And what happened on this play was the Montreal player had his leg over the board, and the puck hit the player coming over the boards before he got on. And that's why the faceoff is right there. Scapinella blew it down.
Richards in for the draw. Won by Ryder after Rivera was waved out of the circle. Comes all the way down ice. Pratt is after it. Pratt taking off the puck. Tampa Bay with a flip. That's broken up. Lightning look to move it out. They can't. Ryder kept it in. Kolesar missed on a chance. In front it goes. Cut off by Saric. Down to Richards. And a vice. Dingman looks along the back end and into the zone. Goes forehand now off the stick of Ryder. Picked up on the line. Atelier. Save made off the blocker by Theodore. Dingman shot by directed his shoelay. Going the other way, but against the grain and went in traffic. And offside is called on Tampa.
Well, I'm wondering. I don't know. You never know with John and Barry.
Zednik's over the line, shooting it. Gloved by Javi Bullen. He gives no rebound. There's another faceoff coming up with a minute 31 to go in the first.
While Richard Zednik was dynamic against the Boston Bruins, anybody that watched that series had to notice Zednik almost every game, especially in game seven. My goodness, they win the game 2-0. He gets both the goals. But so far in this series, when Claude Julien had taken him off this big line, he hadn't done anything, and that's why he reunited this line for game four.
Lightning break out. That pass never made it, though, off the boards. That was the intent. Second Koivu with it. Left side, Markov. Now the breaking Koivu and the Finnish captain will flip it. Ahead for Kovalev. 1:07 to go in the period. Kovalev sweeps it over. Zednik holds. Looks behind the net. Kovalev holds it there. Looking. In front shot. Save on him. There's a rebound. We got a holding penalty.
This is a Tampa Bay penalty. This was an unbelievable save. First of all, it was an incredible pass out by Kovalev. He's played with Wayne Gretzky, so I guess that's where he learned how to do this. Watch this pass, folks, and then off the shaft. He stopped it with the handle of the stick. Do you think this guy's not good? Watch this one again. Off the handle. Off the, sorry, excuse me, the crossbar. Zednik put that off the crossbar, and then Modine was right on top of him, and it's Freddie Modine that ends up in the penalty box. Here's another look at it from inside the net. You'll see what Javi Bullen sees. Beautiful pass out to Zednik. The quick flip, but no such luck. I think it hit the handle and the crossbar, and a bit of a deflection, but Javi Bullen, a tremendous save.
Let's go to Joe McLinney. Joe, what do you have?
Hey, guys, I'll tell you what happened on this. When Zednik was knocked down in front of the net, Daryl Sador thought that he was faking on the play. And so that's why he skated over to him, and he was telling him to get up, kind of using his skates to bump into him a little bit. That's when Kovalev got involved and went over to help protect Zednik. And now as we see Zednik being helped from the ice. Guys?
Thanks, Joe. It looked fairly harmless when you saw the referee call for the hold, but Zednik stayed down.
Well, and the way he fell onto the sticks, I think you're going to see him fall onto sticks here. You can't see it from that angle, but the way he fell down, that probably hurt him. And you know what? That's what happens when you cry possum, and Montreal has cried possum a few times in the playoffs.
Power play is on. Here's Montreal and Surrey's shot blocked and cleared. Montreal has to respect the penalty killing of Tampa Bay and so aggressive. Scored a shorthand goal the other night and scored twice in the playoffs, 15 in the regular season.
You're absolutely right. They have to make sure they know who is on the ice and how strong this penalty killing unit is in opportunities.
How about that hit from Savage on Breezeball?
And here comes the dangerous guys right now. Martin St. Louis is going to come out onto the ice now and be followed by Stillman. Has just gone off. Stillman has just come on, rather. He is very dangerous. He got the shorthanded goal in game three. But these two guys, at any opportunity, get on their horse and fly down the ice.
Fiora leaves it off to Soure. Good first period for Montreal. They've got the lead. Trying to avoid elimination in the second round of the play
here. So this will be a slick ice surface, both for the power play to manipulate the puck around and for quick breaks from this dynamic penalty killing units of the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Brisbois will send it in around the boards. Kept in there. Canadiens deep. Behind the net it goes. The centering pass finds its way to Markov, who backs it up. Markov to the circle with a pass to Ryder. Brisbois, the shot knocked down in front. And Sador gets it and clears it.
And in case you missed it, Richard Zednik is not out here on this power play as he normally would be with Koivu and Kovalev. He went off in the first period after being knocked down by Modine. Actually, that's why Modine is in the penalty box, and it looks like a high ankle sprain.
St. Louis with a flip out of the zone, knocked out by Stillman, who's very dangerous, shorthanded from 60. That one's blocked. Breezeball will get it. 16 seconds left in the Canadiens' power play. Looking to go up by a couple of goals. Breezeball across. Settled in. Look for Koivu. Nice save there by Javi Wulin. And it goes off the netting.
What some great stick handling there by both Kovalev and Koivu. If you watch the way that Kovalev moves his puck, watch this. He goes on the little back pass. That fears the defenseman, Sarich, and he's able to get the shot off. Here it is again, Kovalev, a nifty little back pass. Sarich was moving with Kovalev, and Koivu was able to get the shot off.
Those two guys seem to have a very good chemistry, Koivu and Kovalev. Off this draw. Left circle shot right through the crease. Around it goes. Ribe. Penalty's over on Tampa Bay. Back to full and equal strength. The wraparound. Stop by having a rebound save. Sucks for Bill on his second goal. Here's a big shot that's knocked down on Ribe's stick. Sundstrom came so close to giving Montreal the biggest lead in this series. Cavalier chasing the puck. You can tell it's him because of the booing. Yet he's a Montreal kid, but they don't like what he did to the team so far in this series.
They just simply don't like how good he is, and he's not in red and blue and white.
Around the boards, Soure. Sheldon Soure played almost 10 minutes. That's half of this opening period. Here in the second, this is Sundstrom. This pass knocked down. Canadiens hold it. In front, Bullis snapped away. Jan Bullis nearly had one. At the right point, Markov. Apparently that puck came out. That was close.
Well, the one goal in this game has been scored by Nicholas Sundstrom. He almost has two. If you watch this, watch this. He's right here. He tries to jam it twice. Javi Wulin had everything covered up. There's no way you had been able to get a pee under here. Look at this. The stick's there. The pads are there. There's no place to go. But take a look at it from our Southwest Airlines goal cam. You think you can get anything through there? I doubt it.
Richards with a pass for Stillman. We're back in the live action. Richards behind the net, right through the crease. To the left side. Pratt kept it in. Save the lead for Stillman. Trying to finesse that to Richards. That was a tough pass to even attempt. Montreal breaks up ice over the line. Ribeiro deep. Taking off the stick.
Tampa Bay comes back with a grand pass. Neutral zone rider. Bulas was in ahead of him and now came back out as it's dumped in. Tommy Bula for Saric. Off the boards for Stillman, who played here with St. Louis after a long career with Calgary, settling in here with Tampa Bay. St. Louis around the boards for Richards. He takes the hit, centered it out in front, and the Canadiens try to break out. Koivu detained by Sidor. Perreault, Kovalev. Nice pass inside. Koivu shot high. They have taken a deflection. Soure kept it in. That's Koivu. Dubina chases him down. The pass to Perreault. He tried to find Kovalev, who spins his man around. Sidor takes it. Nearly lost it there, but he finds Perrin breaking 60-footer. That's going to go up off the netting. Four must win for the Canadiens to force a game five. That would be back in Tampa on Saturday night. Mikovic leaves it off. Here's Perrin flipping it. Intended for Dingman. It's a fourth line that's out there right now for Tampa Bay. The down pass up, sent in by Bejean. Canadiens have their fourth line out there as well. Here's down behind the net. Former New Jersey Devil, want a couple of them. Flipping it out in front. Sundstrom lost it there. It's loose. With the side netting. And the Lightning try to move it to the near boards for Dingman. He lost it there. Comes back to Boyle. Lukowicz makes it off the boards. Brought it back in. And now the whistle for an offside as Perrin gets involved late with Bejean.
Well, that goal that Tampa Bay allowed in the first period was only their second road playoff goal allowed in the first periods during this playoffs. If I'm not saying that clearly, there's only been one time that Tampa Bay has allowed a goal on the road in these playoffs this season. And they are also very powerful in the second period. That's actually been the difference. They're 10 goals for, only one against in the playoffs so far this postseason.
It gets stronger the deeper they've gone. Here is Pratt sending it in around the boards. But Cavalier kept it in. Loose puck swatted at. It was by Roy. Pratt will keep it alive. Patrick getting involved in front with Brisebois, trying to take him off his game as the puck comes free to center. Knocked down by Ryder. Michael Ryder over the line, and he just lost it in the end. Ryder takes it in deep behind the net. Double team. Still got a piece of that puck. But now it's LeCavalier. LeCavalier with two-goal games and then one in the last game for Amberchuk. This one is tipped by Theodore, and he stopped that one, too, on the rebound.
Two good saves by Theodore there. They were tipped on the way through to him, but he tracked it all the way.
That's Sidor backing it up for Wong, and he dumps it in on the backhand. Theodore with a flip. On the boards, Canadiens dig it free. Here they come. It could be a two-on-one. Up ice. Kovalev holds. Kovalev trying to shoot. It was blocked by Sidor. Kovalev stays with it. Good puck control by Alex Kovalev for Koivu. Saku Koivu coming in backhand. Stopped in front. Goes to the far boards. Perreault is after it. Flipping it in deep for Kovalev. Nice pass. And then the second pass, a little too fancy. Koivu intended for Perreault.
On that two-on-one, that was a rare bobble by Kovalev. He bobbled the puck, and that's why he couldn't get the shot off.
He doesn't bobble this one. He's got it there in the circle. Here's the cut. He stays with it. Snaps it wide on the short side. Koivu's after it. And now the pass up for Brad Richards. Waits for the help to come. And instead, the back-checking Canadiens take it over. Lead pass was too far. Intended for Sundstrom. Dan Boyle on it. Takes a hit there. Kicks it free. Sundstrom after it. Richards with a clearance. Markov will chase it. Intercepted by Richards with a flip the other way. Greg Rabe on it. Rabe had a couple of assists in game three.
JP, this is Sundstrom's best game in the playoffs so far. Don't forget, he missed the first series with a bad ankle. And it took him a while, even in this series, to get going. I know he felt bad about the goal.
The defensive break was on Bejean for boarding, so it's a power play here. Lightning are 0 for 2 right now with just a couple of shots trying to get themselves back into this game. They're only down by one. Sidor leads the rush. Stays with it to center. Sidor across the line, waits for the help, finds it with Stillman. In front, save! It was Bertuzzi, followed by Theodore Miholzov on the Le Cavalier shot.
A nice one-timer by Vincent Le Cavalier. These guys move the puck around. Great. Stillman with the little thing, a one-timer right there. That's not going to get by Theodore. But again, Theodore is tracking the puck really well.
And the big thing about him, his coach Claude Julien says, I'm not going to say he hasn't played good. He's played good. He's played okay. But he hasn't stood on his head. And that's what they need tonight.
That's what you need to do to win in the playoffs. His save percentage is only .871 in this series. So I'm not sure that he's played great.
Almost 4 goals a game. Stillman with it. You know, during the regular season against Tampa Bay, he was giving up almost 3 a game, so he did not play well against them. Center point, down to the near side, the Kubina shot steered away. Markov, shorthanded, good clear. 119 on the power play for the Lightning. Richards with a couple of power play markers. Comes up, lead pass is blocked. And a break almost for Bullis.
And Bullis and Breezeblock teaming up trying to do what Tampa Bay has done to them.
That's Richards. High off the glass it goes. Kubina. Strong regular season for him. 17 goals. Kubina now with a high dump in. Breezeblock getting there first. Right up the middle, right between the 2 point guards.
And that was pretty chancy by Breezeblock because that wasn't a hard shootout. And had Tampa got to that, it could have been extremely dangerous.
In the corner. Now it comes back to Richards. He starts out 27 seconds left on the man advantage for the Lightning. Dumped it from center ice. Around the boards it goes. Lightning trying to keep it in, and they do with big Andrew Chuck there.
Another penalty to Rive this time for knocking over St. Louis.
Quick shot deflected by Theodore. Possession. Game two. Here's Point. Right circle. Shot high and wide of Theodore. Only 4 seconds on the two-man power play anyway. Here's Boyle keeping it alive. Andrzejczyk, Canadiens get one guy back. In front for the Canadiens block. Andrzejczyk leaves it. Sador in front. Redirected and cleared by Montreal.
What great work there by Francis Boyle. Great penalty kill by Francis Boyle.
Here's Boyle. Starting out power play. Consecutive power plays here for Tampa Bay. Sador fires around the boards. St. Louis keeps it alive. Le Cavalier to Boyle at the point. Brister, Steve wide. Theodore was there with Modine in front. Here's Le Cavalier again. Le Cavalier holds it out of the right point for Boyle. Little corner, St. Louis cycling with Le Cavalier. Up those boards, up high off the glass. St. Louis back for Le Cavalier. Side of the net, now behind the net. Le Cavalier in the forehand. Good patience there. Sador had it stick away. Here's Boyle with a chance in front. And that's blocked, and Boyle has to hustle after. Canadiens more aggressive tonight in the penalty kill.
They certainly are, and blocking all kinds of shots. And again, I can't say it enough, Theodore looks the best he's looked in this series.
Something about elimination games, at least this year, seems to bring out the best in Jose.
Well, it's the pressure. He thrives on pressure, no doubt about it. Don't forget, this guy was MVP of the National Hockey League and the Vezina Trophy winner only 2 seasons ago.
Canadiens win the puck, clear it. Dowd has done so well in the penalty kill and in a reserve role for Montreal. Fedotenko with it. In his own zone with a flip to Richards. 10 seconds left on the Lightning power play. Richards looks for Kubina deep. Vanasenko around the board. Corey Stillman is there. Off the skate of a Vanasenko. And then off the glass. Rive comes out. Vanasenko lost the puck. And here's Rive. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Lightning breaking up. Now it's picked off. Montreal back on the line. Stick work there. Beautiful by Koivu. Sacker wants it. Save. Rebound is loose. Markov. Try for Perreault. Here's Kolesar. Up high, and that's blocked as well. Again, Tampa Bay blocking a lot of shots. Afanasenko drops it off. Stillman looks, drops it. Wrister by Crack, stopped there. Kolesar in the corner with Fedotenko. Koivu. It's a great stick work by Koivu in the other end, nearly resulted in a Montreal goal.
An unbelievable rush by Koivu earlier. Almost ended up in a goal had it not been for Javi Bourne.
Koivu. It's deflected. Kolesar to the left point. Big wide of Soure. And it's off the post. Javi Bourne didn't see it, but now he's got it. Still 1-0. Montreal leading in game 4.
What's that expression? You've got to be good to be lucky and lucky to be good. Well, Habib Boulin is both certainly on this Sheldon Soure blast. Look at that puck. Oh, my goodness. Just wide of the post with 2-0. Southwest Airlines goal cam shows us even better. Look at this. No cigar. Just wide of the net. And the Boulin wall falls back and gets it.
Meanwhile, after that whistle, the Boston shuffle was a penalty on Thomas Sarin. So he's sitting for a couple of crowd, just recognizing that for the announcer as Richards jumps in. So three straight power plays here for Tampa Bay. So far, Montreal has kept them at bay. It's an unsportsmanlike conduct on Thomas Sarin. Not a good time to pick up one of those penalties. At the circle, Andrew Chuck flips it around the boards. Le Cavalier off the skate it in! Oh, you talk about a little luck, as you were saying before. Thiele had no chance. 1-1.
Montreal cannot keep taking these penalties. They are taking some undisciplined penalties. We saw it first with Rabé, we saw it with Bejen, and now it's Komisarek. And what happens? Eventually something finds the net. This one was a pass out. It was never intended as a shot. It goes off the skates. It looks like Dan Boyle and right into the net. Here again, Le Cavalier out for Boyle and into the net. And if you keep taking penalties, that means the other team has possession of the puck most of the time. When the other team has possession most of the time, they're going to find a way to get it into the net. By hook or by crook, it ends up in your net.
And it's taking Montreal out of a rhythm with all of their line combinations because they're killing all these penalties.
Absolutely, and takes the crowd out of the game as well. We talked about second periods for Tampa. Here we go again.
Giving it to Boyle at 11:57. So for Dan Boyle, it's going to be his first goal of the playoffs. We'll see how big a goal that is. Remember back to that save Javi Boulin made when the puck died at the post. That could have been a 2-0 game for Montreal. Instead, it's 1-1 here. See how Montreal responds.
Absolutely.
Down is over the line. Here's the response. Saved by Javi Boulin. Ribeiro. That's his best chance in a while. And I mean in several games. Giving assist to Le Cavalier and Andrichuk on that goal. Good hit there along the boards by Koivu. Here's Bouillon over the line. Going in wide. Puts on the brakes. He's hit there. He stays up with the puck. Pope checked out near the point. Kovalev kept it alive there. Still looks with Modine, and now it's flipped, and that will go out of play. Let's go back to Joe Micheletti.
Okay, thank you very much. Neil, you made an excellent point about taking penalties, Montreal taking penalties. Before the game, I had a chance to sit down with Claude Julien, the head coach of the Canadiens, and one of the things that he was adamant about regarding this game is he said, we can't do what we did last time. We can't be taking penalties and taking ourselves out of the game and putting Tampa Bay on the power play, and it's exactly what's happened. Guys?
Well, I think, Joe, a lot of times a little bit too much exuberance by a guy like Komisarek. He's a young player, and he doesn't know where that line is.
Richards overskates. The goal for Boyle was his first ever NHL playoff goal. Right now, it's a big one that it has tied up this game. 1-1 in game four. Canadiens with it. Bullis. Quick shot. Knocked away by Javi Boulin. Bullis the rebound. Save off the chest. Javi Boulin in a great position for that rebound attempt.
Montreal still out shooting Tampa Bay 19-16 in this hockey game. Here's a couple more shots. A good one-timer. Not real strong, but then Bullis gets the backhander. Javi Boulin's right there. He looks so big when he makes these saves. Look at that. It doesn't look like he got anywhere to put it. Look at this angle. You'll see. Look. He's right with you as you get the puck. There's just absolutely no hole in the Boulin wall when he moves across with you.
He's won his last six games. Less than a goal per game he's given up. Best in the playoffs to this point. At the point, the Brisebois shot redirected. Here's Koivu. Far wing. Around the boards. That's Perron. For Kovalev. Kovalev holds. Puts it on the forehand. Escape. Soure in deep. Soure shot blocked. He didn't have enough on it. They almost broke Le Cavalier.
And at the same time, Sarich got hit with a hard slap shot right in the side of the foot. He just skated it off.
At center, it's broken up. Le Cavalier with a flip. Stillman now to Andrichuk with a flip up high over Theodore. Stillman picks it up. He got there first. Maury Stillman holding. Goes back the other way. Here's Le Cavalier in front for Boyle, who jumped in, and this could be 1-1.
Take a look at the right side of your screen. There's a tug by Boyle on Juno, and apparently he didn't tug him too hard because he gives him a little bit of applause in the penalty box for the dive.
By the Lightning.
What a power play. No goals, but chances. A lot of blocks, too. Here's LeCavalier. Flipping it off the net. Gets it back. He's tied up there. LeCavalier went in hard after he got hit. He's around the boards. Banged in. Sucked off for LeCavalier. Backhand foot for Andrechuk as LeCavalier takes the hit. Kovalev tying up Andrechuk. Loose puck. Kovalev getting it back. He may need to get off for a change. Nearly gave that puck away. And now back up ice. Over the line. Down. Leaves it. Oh, and a bad pass. Picked off. Lead pass to Richards over the line. Drops it. A Fedosenko. Richards blocks it back in it. Richards. Brad Richards will get the goal. Off a turnover at the other end from Dow.
Of all the good things Jimmy Dowd has done in the playoffs so far, boy, oh boy, this was the wrong thing. They were making a change at the time when Dowd made that back pass. If Fedosenkov got it, he gets it back again, a little give and go twice. And the man who broke everybody's hearts in Montreal ends up with another goal. He got the overtime winner in game three. And now this backhander right over top of Theodore. It all starts off with a back pass because the players were changing for Montreal. Dowd didn't recognize that, and he makes the back pass. And away came the Lightning.
I'm not even sure if that red light has ever come on that pass, on that goal. Went upstairs and out.
Let's take another look at it. Brad Richards gets the puck here. There's the give and go with the Fedosenkov and a beautiful backhand shot. What a beautiful backhand attempt right over Theodore's shoulder.
Richards, known for his playmaking the last few years, had a career year with a 26 goals. And also a career high in points. His last pass, going to take over the line. First time in this game that Tampa Bay has led. Flipped in front, on Parrott. Fedotenko couldn't find that one. Here comes Montreal. Pass to the right. Ryder. Checked in by Parrott. Flipped up ice. Fedotenko. Once again, turnovers have cost Montreal. They cut him down from one game to the next, but that Dowd turnover to giveaway results in a goal. Dumped in by Dingman. Picked up by Soure. Around the boards it goes. Ryder's pass. Hoiberg is too bats in way back, but now it comes up to Koivu. They make something out of it. Saku Koivu in. Written into the board. Sarich comes after the loose puck. With Perreault chasing. Perreault won it. With the flex free. Kovalev holds. Nice stick work by Kovalev, but lofted. Got it back. Here is Kovalev. Can't throw it too close to each other. Rive. Kovalev in the corner. Flipped it in front off Javi Bullock's stick. Simply flies the other way. He's off wing, just goes into the zone. We'll go off with a change. 1:13 to go in the second period. Montreal trailing in the series. 3-0 now trailing in the game. 2-1.
Tampa Bay owns second periods in the playoffs so far. Their goal differential is now 12-1.
High flip, 20 bounce there at the line. Backing it up, Brisebois to Markov. Off the boards. The Sundstrom feed over the line. Bejan, hook checked away by Kubina. But Cavalier flies, and he almost got around Markov. He would have had a breakaway. Markov with a recovery. Lead pass off the skate of Sundstrom, who picks it up, dumps it into the zone. Take the first guy on it. Check by Bejan, and the puck comes free. But Cavalier would have flipped the other way. Intended for Modine. Rive is on it. 22 seconds to go in the period. They up 2-1. They almost had too many men on the ice. Just jumped on and came right back off. On the corner, Modine. On the corner. Battle for it there. Five players. One's going to sound in a couple of seconds. And up after two periods. Third period's underway. 5-on-5 hockey. Montreal, one goal down. Sarich will pick it up. Got an icing call. Let's go to Joe Micheletti.
Okay, guys, of course, the Canadiens need to score goals here in the third period, but they're going to have to do it without one of their top goal scorers, and that's Richard Zegras. He is out for the rest of the game. Here is why. In front of the net, you see big Frederick Modine fall on top of him, and you can see here his left ankle, his left lower leg. All the weight goes on top of that. He was helped off the ice. He will not return.
Nice. Tough break there for the Canadiens. Here is the loose puck, and Richards has it blocked by Guillaume. Sorek goes. Brisebois with a pass. Mentioned Zetting has not had a good playoff round here compared to the opening round. They put it back to the big line to get him going.
And he was playing extremely well tonight.
Richards in front. That goes wide on Modine's redirect.
When Zednik did get hurt in front of the net, it was Daryl Sador that was sort of poking at him, saying, get up, you're faking. Well, this time he wasn't.
Sador to Kubina. As Tampa Bay tries to close out Montreal and sweep them. In four. Another whistle.
Well, one of the big differences has been the power play time for both the teams. You see it right there, and the Montreal Canadiens made a big mistake giving the Lightning this much power play time. Yes, they have only come up with one power play goal. That was a Dan Boyle deflection off of his skate. However, when you put that much time in the penalty box, it tires out your penalty killers. It tires out your best players. Montreal took three straight penalties in the second period, and they were all penalties that could have been avoided.
And as badly as Tampa Bay's power play has struggled in the playoffs and now scored in the last couple of games, actually three of them. The last three games, going back to game two in Tampa when the Cavaliers scored for 5-on-3. John Tortorella's team trying to close out this series. First time in the Lightning short history they've ever had a 3-game-to-none lead in the last of seven. Soray with it. Off the boards. Perreault flipping it ahead. Saku Koivu. Now to Yannick Perreault. The veteran lost a bit of Kubina. The glass picked up by Perrin. Got a hand pass.
And the thing that you've got to be wondering is, can the Montreal Canadiens rally? Can they get their confidence up? Can they get the boiling point going again like they had in the first period? They've got to get it going. They've got to realize desperation is almost a small word for what they've got to do this period. They've got to go out and do whatever they can, or else it's back to the golf course.
Face-off, neutral ice. It'll go to Pratt. Pratt will swing it over. Right side, Sarich. Cross rink it goes to Fedotenko. The ex-flyer dumps it in. Behind the net, the Cavalier's pass intercepted. Juno throws it off the boards. Lukowicz on his horse to get this. rushing up to it, flips it around the boards, but it's Hengo's hounded. Here's Kovalev's pass that's blocked and picked up by Boyle. See the way it looks for Boyle. He is wrapped around somebody, and now, gotta call this, it's Boyle and Dow. And is it gonna be one or both? Mick McGrew's coming over to make the call.
Yes, it's both. He's getting Dowd and Boyle.
Boyle has scored his first career playoff goal earlier. We'll be sitting out for a couple of minutes.
Well, watch how this all starts. A little slash there by Jimmy Dowd. They come together and wrap themselves around each other in an embrace. Not the friendly kind of embrace, however.
So two each, so it's four-on-four hockey, all kinds of open ice here at the Bell Center. Where the ice has been far better, obviously, than in Tampa because of the heat and humidity down there. Players from both teams are complaining about the ice there.
Well, Claude Julien's role players have come through really nicely in this game so far, but this, in the end, here is where Koivu and Kovalev have got to come. If there's anybody who's going to deliver them overtime or a win in regulation, it's going to be Kovalev and Koivu. They're the guys, and they haven't played poorly, but they got to get a puck in the net.
Mike Richards has. Here is Brad Richards stopping. Flipping it around the boards towards Modine. Poked the head. Here's Ryder coming back. And the rookie, plus three on the right. Lukowicz got a piece of him, not all. Ryder bounced right back up. Goes down again. And there's Modine. Ryder took two hits there. Lead pass off the boards intended for Richards. Too far. Theodore looks. Miscommunication there. Finally, the icing call.
Well, there goes Michael Ryder on the bench after taking a little bit of a rough ride from Lukowicz right there. And then he gets back up, and Corey Serge gives him a little shot right there. There's a hip check by Lukowicz. Just almost slid by, and then Corey Serge comes in and whoops right over the top. So Michael Ryder, he looks a little bit nervous in this game so far. Not getting the shots off quite as well, not thinking quite as fast as normal.
Here's Rive, firing it up high. And it was knocked down again by Tampa Bay.
Tampa Bay leads in block shots coming into the third period, 16-13. 16 block shots by Tampa, 13 by the Habs.
Kovalev with Koivu. Trying to play it across to Rive, and a breakout pass. Here's Perrin over the line. Big slapper. And no rebound for Theodore. Now he lets it go for Markov. And then to Kovalev. That's Granger and Penguin. Broken up there, St. Louis, another giveaway for Montreal. Knocked down by Theodore. It's a good thing he got that away from LeCavalier. Markov the other way. Montreal changing on the fly. How many guys do they have out there? Rick Rister goes wide. Of Javi Bulin. At the left point, Soure with a flip. Tapped off Saric. And then Montreal loses the puck.
It's like a pinball game in front of Javi Bulin. Nothing gets through. It hits one leg, another leg, a stick. It never quite gets through to Javi Bulin.
Rivero leaves it off. Here's Soure with open ice. Let's it rip from 60. Glove by Javi Bulin. He hangs on. Soure looking for his first ever playoff goal. He's talking today about getting shots off quicker because of the way Tampa Bay defends. You don't have many opportunities against them.
You sure don't. And one guy who can shoot the puck is Sheldon Soure. There, if you take a look at Jose Theodore and his record in elimination games, he's hit three of them came against the Boston Bruins. Talking about Sheldon Soure, he won the hardest shot competition at the All-Star game, so he can really gun the puck. What a season he's having. 15 regular season goals this year. That was more than he had in his whole career combined.
Kubina around those boards. Pinto lost it there. Lightning with it. They've got the lead 2-1, 16 minutes perhaps left in the Montreal Canadiens season. Theodore around the boards. Montreal trails in the best of 7, 3-0. Down in this game, 2-1. The crowd trying to pick him up here. Dumped it around the boards, Komisarek. We haven't seen him since he took that bad penalty in that last period. And now it's clear.
And Tampa Bay is doing just what they did in game 3, JP. Every time they're now dumping it in, they're putting it in and chasing after. They weren't doing that. That's not their normal game. That's their protecting a lead game.
5-on-5 as St. Louis shot is blocked. St. Louis again in the corner. He came into this game with a 6-game point streak. It's sent away again at the side of the net. Goes behind the wrap around in front of his block. He had a second try, but it stopped. Second point. Off the boards. Komala with six goals in the playoffs. Leads Montreal. Dumps it in behind Javi Bourdin. Around the boards. Richards digs it out. Richards with a go-ahead goal tonight. Had two the other night, including the game winner in overtime. Kovalev, stick handles. That's well done. Kovalev wide to the corner and now in front. We have Perreault. This is Perreault to the right point.
Rebate fire. Blocked again. McCallier. Could be a 3-on-2.
Leads it up for Stillman over the line. Modine trying to finesse it back and it's blocked. Kubina keeps it alive. Knocked down by Markov. And the Canadiens take it out. Up and down hockey from Montreal at the Bell Center. Kovalev slides it over. That's Brutus. Still with the puck, turns around. It's stopped by Javi Bourdin.
A nice attempt, though, by Bulas on that turnaround shot. That's the only kind of shots that are getting through. When you come around on the backhand, everybody goes with you, and then you whip around and shoot it forehand.
Neutral zone, Soure. On the dump it. Into the corner it goes. Wider for the flip. Bulas came in late. Ribeiro to Bulas. Ribeiro on the side, now behind the net. Looks to come around. Open man at the point. Breezeball. Now to Ribeiro on the side. Breezeball gets in a point. The crowd begging him to shoot. At the left circle. Quick shot. Stopped to the side. Well, after all the conversation about getting off the shots quickly, you couldn't tell by that sequence. Breezeball chasing it.
Well, John, I wonder if there's a Joe Sakic in a Montreal uniform tonight. Will somebody step up like that last night and extend the series? We'll find out. Still another 13-19 to go in regulation time. 2-1 Tampa Bay. Up 3-0 in the series. Around the boards it goes. From the side. Sundstrom lost it there. Quick shot in. Just save. Turnaround shot. Save on that.
What a save. What a save by Theodore. That could be a game saver. That could be a series saver if Montreal can get a goal.
Remember that save if Montreal comes back and wins his hockey game. That's the kind of play they wanted from Theodore, standing on his head, as Claude Julien said. That's what they need. Not faulting the goaltender, certainly, but knowing that he could play at a higher level, they saw it in the last series.
Well, on tonight's two goals by Tampa Bay, you could not fault Theodore.
One was that deflection. Escape. And the other was a great goal by Richards on the break. This is Rive backing it up. Now Markov. Leads it off Perreault. Kovalev. You would expect Kovalev and guys like Koivu will get a lot of ice time here in the third. Kovalev goes down, gets it up to Koivu. Rushing is Markov. Andre Markov will hold. Flips it around the board. Koivu there with Pratt. It hops Rita Sarich. And out of the zone it goes into the Montreal end. Yannick Perreault. To Kovalev. Koivu's pass deflected. Kovalev got it again and flipped it into the Tampa Bay Lightning end. Sidor flying. Avoided one check. Still going with the puck. Darryl Sidor will just flip it in. On the side around the boards. Mike Ryder flips it ahead. Jan Bulas turning. Nice pass and off the stick of Ribeiro. Ribeiro takes it to the corner, then he's taken into the boards by Kubina. Ribeiro got it free behind the net. Jan Bulas went into the traffic area. Bulas finds Soure at the left point. Right point. Komisar hit the side netting, it looked like. Around the boards for Stillman. He's checked there by Ryder. Ribeiro comes in. Sidor's in for Richards. Poking out his Komisar. He left his spot. And now it's Modine. Long shot wide.
Komisar came off the boards to go in on that one. He shouldn't have. He should have stayed hard on the boards. Tampa Bay was under pressure. He wouldn't have been able to get it out.
So back in the neutral zone. Tampa Bay Lightning leading 2-1 for Montreal. This is game four. Lightning trying to close out the series and sweep the Canadiens. Montreal hasn't been swept in the playoffs since 98 against Buffalo. Soure off the boards. The drive. Intercepted. Here's Perreault. Holding in the circle.
played it across. He was looking for Andre Roy, the fourth line out there for Tampa Bay.
The Canadiens are really having trouble getting through the neutral zone of Tampa Bay as it clogged up. It's like trying to get drive to a field of corner.
There's Dingman. Sounds like he might have tried that at one time. Dingman with a dump in. Theodore out of his nets. Leaves it for Bouillon. Under 10 minutes to go. Third period from Montreal in a noisy Bell Center. They don't want the season to end, and it's going to, unless Montreal can come back in this one. If they can, game five is Saturday in Tampa. Coleman over the line on the off wing. Waits for the half in the front. Hucked by a couple of players. Goes back behind the net. Crack, pop, board, giveaway. Freeze block keeps it in. Perron. Canadiens keep it alive. Kubina around the boards. Vanasenko couldn't get through. We all kept it in, apparently there. Kovalev had it poked away. And the chuck. Taylor. On a bounce. Picked up and offside on Tampa Bay. Here's Joe McAlenny.
Hey, guys, you've talked about Brad Richards scoring the second goal of this game. He's had a tremendous offensive season, but it hasn't always been easy. He went through a streak in the middle of the year where he scored only one goal in 19 games. I asked him what he did to change things around. He said he tried everything. He finally got a phone call from his dad, who had been watching all the games on television, and he said, "You're using a stick that's too short. Use a longer stick and things will change." Well, the stick he's using now is 2 inches longer than the one he started the season with, and things have obviously gone well for him. Guys?
Hey, who needs scouts when you have dads like that?
But if he's doing better with a longer stick, he might want to get a hold of one of Cherry's sticks. Maybe he'd be a 50-goal scorer, because this guy's on fire.
Cavalier bringing along the boards, kicking it free. Tampa Bay trying to close out the Canadiens. Another goal might just do it here with 8:36 to play in regulation. The flip by the Lightning. Trying to keep the Canadiens bottled up in their own zone. Joey Junot starting out. Still has the good wheels. Up or down. Over the line. He goes wide. Bejan broken up. Down keeps it going in front. It's not behind the net. Picked up again by Bejan. Junot.
That's bad. One of the Canadiens has got to get out. Here's a penalty.
Yeah. It's a bad play, but Boyle took over. And he bailed him out, really, with that cross shot.
And we see 1 second gone off the clock on the penalty. I wonder if they're going to reset this, JP. I'm sure they are on a false faceoff.
Sure. They may not be aware of it. Nope. Off the draw. Breeze one, the most important power play of the season, really, right now for the Canadiens. Held up, now to Koivu, out to Markov. It hops free to the circle. Played out center point. Breeze one fires it, he missed again. It came back on the kid, and Javi Boulin's got it.
You know what? The biggest save of that whole sequence was Javi Boulin saving the rebound off the board. He was so quick to turn around and snuff that out that even Perreault couldn't get to it. Look, watch that. What a save.
Yeah.
What a save off the backboard. Southwest Airlines goal cam shows us how quick Javi Boulin is. Look at this. Reaches back. Boom. He's got it before Perreault can get his stick on.
It's ironic. It's a great play, but it wouldn't count as a save as that one was wide. But a big play by Hunter.
Absolutely. It's not, it doesn't count as a save, but it might be the biggest save.
Yeah. Perreault over the line. And a whistle for an offside.
Kovalev almost pulled his groin trying to stay onside there, but a little shift in momentum threw him offside on that one.
Well, you talk about pressure and drama. 7:16 to go, perhaps, in this Canadian season. The power play has 1:19 left on it. And Montreal are in desperate need of a goal just to tie this one up. Brisebois from center ice around the boards. Saric missed it. Modine won't miss it. Nice breakout pass. St. Louis drags the puck and waits. Just trying to kill some time right now. St. Louis takes it in deep. That's a one-man gang right there.
St. Louis caught deep right now.
Koivu to Kovalev over the line. Alex Kovalev drops it. Perreault wasn't expecting it, but he's got it back. Put Kovalev in the corner. At the circle. three-pointer. Looks. Markov between the circles now pulls it back to the point. High-wrister is tipped wide by Kovalev. Sidor off the boards. Pitching, but not making it stay in the zone for the Canadiens. Kovalev's over the line. By himself at the moment as he's checked there. And here's Tampa Bay again. Still dumping it.
Huge kill for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Huge with only 13 seconds to go on the power play.
Soy with a dump it. Power play still has 7 seconds left. That's it. Montreal digs it out. No shot there. Ryder goes down with Carvino. Round the boards. Penalty's over. Montreal still with the puck. Left point, Soy. The shot tip wide on the save by Javi Buller. Rivera to Ryder. At the point, poked away by Tim Taylor, the veteran. And Montreal must start again with 5:33 to go in their season. That's what it's looking like at the moment. Ryder behind the net. Out in front of the net, this lodged. A break in the action. Still, Tampa Bay leads by one. Ghost may be helping out the Canadiens. Well, he's not going to be able to score any goals, but they could use some help on the ice. A team that's won 23 Stanley Cups in the NHL and one in the NHA is almost out of this playoff. They need a goal just to tie in right now. 5:24 left in regulation. And Tampa Bay with a strong third period, not giving up much. Bouillon. To the left for Breesbaugh. A rolling puck gathered in by the Lightning, and they just don't. Breesbaugh left side to Bouillon. Off the boards intended for Dowd. Cut off by Tampa Bay. Dowd back for it. Jimmy Dowd waiting. Banks it off the boards for Bouillon. The Palliers after him. So is St. Louis. Montreal can't get it out of their zone. And the time continues to tick on. Flipped around the boards. Breesbaugh. Nice pass up the middle. Juno. 3-on-2. Left side, Bejan. His shot sticked away by Javi Gould. In front it goes, but there's nobody there in the red uniform.
Nobody going to the front of the net at all. And that's where Bejan put it, but nobody was there but white jerseys.
Flipped around the boards by Theodore. 4:15 to play. And right now it's in the Canadian season. Coyle with the dump in. Sidor. Checked hard there. That's got the crowd going. And Sidor maybe hurt.
Really got their defense core going.
Lightning will play it up. Neutral zone on the dump in. 3:53 remaining in this hockey game. 2-1. Tampa Bay trying to close this series up. Long for Perreault to Kovalev. He and Pratt together. Perreault centers it. Koivu stopped somewhere there by Javi Buller. He doesn't dare move.
Incredible. What a great play that was by Perreault to Koivu. An even better play by Koivu to make sure that he got that puck on net. This was really bouncing around. Look at that. Quick pass, a bouncing puck, and the shot by the captain. But you know what? Javi Buller, just you can't get things by him. The only goal that's gone by him tonight has been by Nicholas Sundstrom on a backhand.
Off that faceoff, Dubina plays it up. Montreal back in their own zone. Soray. And that's too far for anybody. The icing's waved off. Now it's not. Trailing official had it. Now instead, it's Sidor on the boards. Breesbaugh deflects out to Bulas. Ribeiro looking. Try to drop it off, and he does. Ryder pin there. Four players take a whack at it. Anderchuk couldn't get it. Second effort from Anderchuk. Smart play off the boards.
And everything Tampa's done this period has been smart. Everything. They tap it off the boards. They tap it into the zone. They forecheck well. Everything Tampa's done has been letter perfect.
A well-coached hockey club. John Tortorella's team ran away with the Southeast Division this year and also won the division a year ago. Theodore out of the net.
That could have been dangerous, and it is. Modine has it. Now to Richards. The longer Tampa Bay has the puck, less likely it is for Montreal to come back. Modine looking, trying to set it in front for Richards. Montreal just wasted a lot of time there, Neil.
Well, we talked about it before. Everything Tampa's doing has been the perfect way to protect the lead.
And a whistle there for the icing, and now everybody getting in.
You can hear Mick Magoo yelling at these guys. That was a hit on an icing call. They're not going to call it a penalty at this point in the game. But that doesn't stop Lukowicz from being upset that he got hit by Steve Bégin after he touched the puck for icing. And there you see Big Sheldon Soure come in and have a few words for Lukowicz. Lukowicz and Sador, we've talked about this before, best friends. Sador was the best man at Lukowicz's wedding when they were both on Dallas. And guess what? Lukowicz got a call that wedding day on June 22nd, 02. He traded to the Tampa Bay Lightning. That was the wedding day.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. But true. Faceoffs won, all Canadiens for the most part tonight. 208 left. Junot and LeCavalier. Look out there, that one hopped in front. Bégin with it. Pratt kept it in. Shot knocked down. LeCavalier fakes. Now dumps it in again, another smart play. Now picked up by Soure. We'll keep our eyes on Theodore when he might be pulled for the extra attacker. Both coaches, if they want, have a timeout to call.
Let's see if Claude Julien uses his timeout. He didn't use it in game two, and he did use it in game three.
Kovalev's over the line. Looking, snapping it. And it's blocked off the netting. It'll be a faceoff coming up.
And here's where one of the timeouts should come. A minute 35 to go in the game. Let's watch the benches and see if either one of these coaches call it. My guess is that Julien would call it first, but it doesn't look like he's going to. He's looking towards Theodore right now, giving him some head signals about when to come out. Again, I got to emphasize it to you, JP. He hasn't used his timeout in any of these games.
Faceoff won by Montreal. Surprising with a faceoff there in the offensive zone. They didn't pull a freeze ball shot. Steered away. Javi Rula. And now the clearance. And now they want to get Theodore out, but the puck's in the neutral zone. There's Markov. The flip. Dumped it by Coach.
There he goes, JP.
He's all ready at the bench. Extra skater on for Montreal. Their season is on the brink of collapse here. As the puck goes free into the empty net. Picked up off the boards. Modine can walk it in and end this one, and he does. Frederick Modine makes it 3-1. 3-1 Tampa Bay. In game. You've got to wonder about that timeout that you talked about before, and also not pulling the goalie with the faceoff that deep the other way as Montreal fans head for the exits.
They certainly do, and they'll just see it here come off the boards. A great little tip. Frederick Modine chases after the puck. Breezeblock can't catch him. Markov can't catch him. And a big, wide-open, gaping net for Freddie Modine.
At 1904, that's a killer for Modine. And you can see this building very much on the emptier side now.
And the fans litter the ice in Montreal after that goal on their way out in disgust, upset that their Montreal Canadiens are going to be swept out of the playoffs by the Tampa Bay Lightning. This hasn't happened since 1998 when the Buffalo Sabres did it. They actually did it the same way, swept them out in Montreal. Montreal has faced this situation 8 times in the past, been down 3 games to none. And in that situation, they had actually won game 4 5 times. They've only lost it 3. Now they'll have lost it 4 times and have won it 5 times. This is the 9th time for this storied franchise.
Fedosenkov and an Andrychuk getting assist on the Modine goal. Baseball tonight is coming your way next here on ESPN. Right after Tampa Bay celebrates. 55.3 left in a 2-goal lead.
Well, congratulations to John Tortorella and his squad. A worthy winner of this round. Certainly, they've done almost everything right. They did it right. This third period,
was picture perfect, the way they played this period. The goaltending was great. The defense was great. The way he got this team, which is a fast-breaking team, to keep chipping it out and playing a simple game. They're a team that doesn't play a simple game when they're going hard, but in the third period, John Tortorella had his squad doing that, backed up, of course, by this guy, who's just been unbelievable. If the Conn Smythe trophy was handed out after this round, he'd be the winner.
Yep. Hands down.
Well, those fans that are still here are cheering on the Montreal Canadiens as we thought they might. They're great supporters here. Sheldon Surrey's called them the best fans in the NHL.
There goes Theodore again.
To the bench he goes, a 3-1 Tampa Bay lead. Trying to close out the series. Saric off a deflection of the four boards. Modine will chase after, 28 seconds left. Perron deflected towards Koivu. Left point Markov. Shot redirected wide. Crack. First guy there. Bangs it off the glass. Near side it comes, and the Lightning clear it out. Net's empty. Richards' flip goes deep. 10 seconds to go. 3-1, Tampa Bay. They're going to go on to the next round with a sweep of the Montreal Canadiens.